Gelatos.
I love gelato.
Today I'm going to be demonstrating peach gelato for you. And the first step for a peach gelato is we need to clean the peaches. You're going to take the peaches, you're going to make a nice little score, which is a little X right across the bottom of it. You're going to take it, you're going to drop it into boiling water. Water's not quite boiling yet, but it'll work. The second step is going to be to peel the peach when it has started to cook on the outside. I wouldn't say they're the best ever, but they're definitely the best this side of Italy.
I'm Italian.
Oh wow, that's a lot of Italians. This better be good gelato then.
Gelato?
Oh, I'm sorry for my mispronunciation.
Are you Italian?
Oh no, I'm Portuguese myself. Because that's what we make over at A Tavola. Yes.
What's that?
All right, so I'm going to start the gelato base now. You add the sugar, water, and eggs into a bowl over a double boiler. You're going to sit and whisk. And this is a long whisking process. Yeah, I'm going to get very tired during this, but it's well worth for the texture and the flavor of the gelato. Slowly the gelato base will start to thicken up, it'll start to become more pale yellow, and you'll see it as the process goes. So I'm going to deal with this peach. Would somebody like to whisk the gelato?
I will. I'm real Italian. Like this.
So now we're going to take the peach that is already scored on top, and you're just gonna peel back from the X's.
How long should I mix it for?
Oh, keep going.
Keep going.
You're gonna probably wanna trade turns with somebody. The skin's gonna give a little bit of bitterness, even though it does give great color. It's not quite what we're looking for today. One peach would probably be good enough for a half batch of gelato, which is roughly a quart.
Wait, you're making it for people?
This is what a quart is. It would be one gelato thing this size.
Could I have some?
Oh, of course. It's. I'm going to have plenty of gelato for everybody today.
Wait, did it buy like
gelato? Did I buy what? Yes. That, and it starts to cook the fruit, which releases sugars in the fruit. So from here, you go, you're gonna wanna take the pit out, take the fruit, and you're gonna wanna put it into a blender. You may need to add a little bit of water, not much. Oh no, we're using imagination today. So you're gonna take the fruit, put it into a blender, blend that up, and you wanna reserve that over to the side. Then you're gonna go back to the gelato base. And this is starting to get there. It's not quite there yet though. It'll start to become nice and thick and you'll be able to make ribbons with it. Yep. Gelato has egg in it, so you need to bring it up to a certain temperature to allow it to be served to people. This is how I make it. This is my recipe that I've developed over the past 6 or so months at A Tavola. Oh, feel free. So as you can see, the gelato is starting to thicken up. It's a lot thicker than it was when I first poured everything in there. The sugar in the egg is starting to come together. Oh, this is going to get very thick. It's going to get to the point where it kind of hurts to even work it. All right, so this is about the thickness that you want to get it to. Right about a pudding texture, almost custardy. If it was too cool, it would be a very...
You guys have so many questions.
Yeah. From this point, when the egg base with the sugar has reached this texture, you're going to want to add the milk in. It's milk, sugar, and eggs. That's all the gelato is. Try to bring it as natural as we can for you. And again, you're going to want to do it and whisk and whisk and whisk, and eventually it's going to come back to that same texture it was before you added the milk. And that's what we're really looking for. It's that custard texture that really brings out the flavor and the texture of the gelato. This is a long process, but I swear it's worth it. As you see, the milk is starting to thicken up. It's really starting to foam. Really thickens up from the bottom where the surface area is getting the heat from the double boiler. And man, is my arm tired. Alright, now this is just about to where I want it to be. It's going to start thickening it up real quick. So from this point, what I would do is I would take this off the heat. I would throw this over another bowl of ice. And I would quickly, as fast as I can, bring the temperature down. That way we have safe gelato for everybody. You want to bring it down to about 40 degrees. And at this point, if you were doing this at home, you'd want to already have your home spinner, whatever type of hand crank, the soccer ball, it doesn't really matter. It's going to make the same quality of gelato. It's the imagination today. Here's the ice bath. So, we're going to use a little bit of TV magic here, folks. Boom, that goes down. And hey, look, the gelato has been spun. Oh, thank you very much, people. Thank you. Yeah, I'll leave that there so it doesn't melt anything. All right, who wants some gelato? Oh, I didn't think anybody wanted gelato, right? Nobody?
I do.
This is the peach gelato. I made this yesterday. This is a berry coulis, a little bit extra just to give it a little bit of more flavor. Oh, more flavor for everybody?
I'm so sorry.
All right, who's first? Extra flavor?
I do.
Extra flavor for one. Here you go, and a spoon for you. Extra flavor? Extra flavor. Extra flavor. Extra flavor?